I think it is very fascinating, the sensation that you're digging, and so you're revealing information all the time. And although I didn't know very much about what I was finding, if one's working on a site for a while, one knows one's looking for post holes or something. And of course, on a Roman site, then one's finding stuff all the time. It's not like some prehistoric sites where you sort of find one flint a day or something. You're digging up pottery all the time, nice Samian ware and so on. And the occasional coin, which is naturally a highlight if you're digging. And so I enjoyed that very much. And certainly the sensation that you're trowelling and you're being asked by the supervisor to try and follow this layer, and then you find there is a floor, and you can, if you do it the right way, you can uncover the whole floor rather successfully. The actual materiality, the quality of the soil, I think is something one gets to have a feel of. I don't think at that time I learnt to be a very wonderful excavator, but there is, in many ways in archaeology, I think the physicality of the subject is attractive, that you do things and you're digging, and then sometimes you're using a pickaxe and shoveling it away, and so you're actually actively involved. So I enjoyed it very much, but I don't think I was particularly, I wasn't given any huge responsibility. I wasn't drawing many sections at that time, or I suppose I was keeping a notebook, but I think there was another site supervisor, because I was still quite young, sort of 13, 14, 15. It wasn't until rather later that while I was up at Cambridge, I went down to Wroxeter, to the field school there, and that was much more systematic, where one was keeping notebooks and writing them up in the evening and drawing sections. That's when I had learnt to draw a section properly and so on. And I think it is helpful to have those basics because it's just sort of nice to know how the recording system works. But certainly being in the excavation trench seemed very natural after I was at Canterbury for several years in succession, a couple of weeks at Easter and usually a couple of weeks in the summer. I think Sheppard Frere put up with me very well. I'm not sure I was a great deal of use, but they were always very nice. And certainly one does do things. I remember finding individual grains of corn and thinking, that's rather interesting. Is that interesting? No, that's of no interest. Throw it away at once. In later years, of course, opinions change on these matters. But it was a very good experience.